Welcome. I know you're probably thinking, how do I do labs online? Well, physical geography is really well suited for online labs because physical geography uses computers as a primary tool.
So it's not this kind of lab. So we will use computers to analyze digital data in many forms, interpret digital maps and graphs, and visualize scientific phenomena. In this video, I will go over how to approach the labs in this class. Labs are introduced approximately every 2 weeks. You should start working on the lab in the week that it opens. Start your lab assignment by clicking on the lab link in modules. Let's take a look at lab 1. You will see two videos and a hyperlink when you open the lab. The first video is a concept video, which covers one of the key lab science concepts we will tackle in this class. The second video is an overview of the lab itself. The link is the lab handout. The handout contains additional lecture material and the procedure and questions in the lab. Below the lab handout is the rubric for the lab. This is what I will use when I grade your lab, so it's really important that you read it over as you are answering the questions in the lab handout. When you are ready to turn in your lab, click on the blue button in the upper right. Click on the Browse button to upload the file from your computer. When you are ready, you can click on Submit Assignment to turn your assignment in. Remember, your lab is due at 11:30 a.m. on the due date that is posted in the syllabus. You can turn things in up to 4 days late. However, you get 10% off for each day late, so don't make a habit of turning things in late. I'd like to take a minute here to talk about collaboration in science. Science is not done in a vacuum. The best ideas of scientific discovery happen when you talk over ideas with others. The same goes for learning. You learn more when you work with other people. I really encourage you to build a study group, either at your local coffee shop or the library or online. Talk over the lab questions with your study group. However, it's really important that you do your own write-up. That is why when you look over the grading rubric associated with each lab, the majority of the points are awarded for showing work, not arriving at the correct answer. That's not to say you can't help each other, but you need to write up your own lab submission. So to review, let's take a look at how to tackle labs in Canvas. First, go to Modules and open up the lab. Watch the concept video and the introductory lab video. Next, open up the lab handout. Read the whole thing. Open a separate word processing document and write up your answers to the questions. To get additional help, do not hesitate to post in the Frequently Asked Questions forum or to use the tutorial services available, both on campus and online. For more about these, see the Module 1 resources or click on NetTutor. In the second week, continue working on your material, check in with your study group, talk over your answers with them, and post in the Frequently Asked Questions or check in with NetTutor if you get stuck. Finally, log back in before 11:30 a.m. on the posted due date to turn your lab in. Labs can be submitted up to 4 days late with 10% off for each 24 hours late. Remember, this is a guided inquiry learning experience. I want you to have fun with it and to learn more about the wonderful world outside your front door. Happy trails!